out my earpiece. Oh my goodness. So thank you for typing that in so that I know nobody could hear me. So let me just start this over. I'm just jumping on real quick to do a real quick scope. I was trying to do a live from a new software that I'm looking at to see if we can better do things from the computer. And I am at a client event right now, and the internet is just not really solid here, so it wasn't connecting. But I felt that it was a word. No, it's the platform is from Switchboard Live called Joycaster. Been looking for ways to stream on multiple platforms from the computer, and so I'm just been testing a few out. So, but the venue I'm at, the Wi-Fi is not great, and I'm luckily at my clients really didn't need internet services for their meeting, so that was, and they liked it, so that's why we're here. But so in my makeshift office, but I had a little quick word that I wanted to at least come on line and, just speak about just some things that I've been going through this past week, and just made me and had me, work. Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining me. And it's called Walking the Path, and it's based on one of my favorite scriptures. It is Jeremiah 29th chapter 11th verse, and it says, "I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end." And I'm gonna be honest, like, I'm really not much of a movie buff, but I have my few, and I have my classics that I like or whatever. And one of my favorite movies is The Matrix. The part one, Matrix part one. There's been several things that's been happening over the past week. And then I just have a couple of incidences that have just sent me spinning and just kind of knocked me off my kilter. And I'm just been off. Yes, I love The Matrix. Trust me, I do. And it has some great lessons in there. And so as I reflected on a lot of the things that's been happening this week, there was a particular, point in, the movie that came to mind as I was going through these things. And if you remember, if you saw part one, there was a part when right after Morpheus went and rescued Neo and brought him in and unplugged him, and he was still in this, phase of there's doubt and, I think I know what I'm doing, but I'm really not sure. And at that point, Morpheus says to him, "There's a difference between knowing the path and walking the path." And when you know the path, you have your rose-colored glasses on. You remain in that comfort zone. You never push for more. Because where you are at, you stand, nothing more is required of you. And I've been there because I'll stay in this area because nothing more is going to be required of me, and I don't have to push past what I know. You believe what others tell you, and it's hard because you can't see past the limitations in which they've placed on you. All you see is just little quick little slow box, and you're comfortable and you're okay with that. And so, but when you begin to walk the path and begin to decide that you're going to, do the things, that's when the plot thickens. That's when the trials come. That's when the adversity strikes. But that's also when the purging process begins. And walking the path, you now have become a threat to Satan and his kingdom. And he will do whatever he can do to stop your walk. And I know this for a personal fact, because as long as I was just chill, as long as I was cool, as long as I was just low-lying, just staying below the radar, life appeared to be great. It appeared that I had everything that I needed and I wanted. But when I started questioning about what do I need to do, where do I need to go, I'm doing so well. I hope you're blessed. You know, that's when I decided that I needed to go higher and I needed to be obedient and do the things that needs to be done. And what I want to help do is dispel the myth that once I commit to Christ, once I give my life to them, everything is going to be rosy and it's all going to just work out. And that's a myth. Yes, I can and will. You know, that's a med. So when you give your life to Christ, that is when the enemy really comes in, because now you've become a threat. When you out there flossing and doing what you want, when you want, how you want, getting that fast money, you ain't a threat to him, because you doing what everybody else in his camp is doing. But when you decide to live for Christ and really begin to do the things he wants you to do, that's you become the threat. And sometimes, even you're living for Christ and your life is good, sometimes he will do you like he did Job. He'll walk up to God and be like, if I was to take everything from her or him, they're going to curse you. They're only doing that because you just making it easy for them. You done gave them the plush job. They got all the family. They got everything they need. But the minute you let me put my hands on them, they're going to walk away. So don't walk away. Don't curse God and die. Either way, you have to walk in your purpose. You know, and what people don't get is that we've become this microwave society. We want it fast. You know, we don't want to work for it. You know, we know our purpose. Some of us do. And we see it clearly. But we don't want to walk in it because it requires us to do more than just the status quo. Oh, and I'm good for it. I've been there. And some aspects of my life, I'm there still. I'm getting better. You know, I was good at complaining about not being fulfilled, but being okay with being complacent with the status quo. You know, I've realized in the past few days that I can no longer do that. I can no longer just keep quiet and just be like, okay, I'm just going to just fly below the radar. You know, God is showing me that there's so many other people that are dependent on me being transparent, on dependent on me just, you know, saying what my truth is and letting them know that, you know what? Yeah, it looks like I have it all together, but I struggle just like everyone else. And no, you know, there's times where it is hard and it's tough. And there's times that I have conversations with God, be like, excuse me, what is going on? Okay. And anybody who tells you they don't have those conversations with God, you need to show me who they are so we can have a conversation. Because I don't know who they serving. You know, there's times where you just don't wonder. You wonder, why is he allowing these things? And why is he taking you through all of this drama and all this craziness? But it's a purging process. It is a perfecting process. And it is going to be painful sometimes. But it is worth it. It is worth it. It is worth it because someone else who is struggling like you're struggling is going to see that you're persevering and making it and that they can make it. You know, your life is an example and an inspiration to someone else, to people that you don't even know, to people that you may not even see. So continue to live. Continue to work, continue to push forward, continue to go through those trials and those tribulations, and continue to read your word, stay in your word, and do not allow anyone outside of your purpose to knock you off of your purpose. You know, I want to end with this. When someone is giving you advice, take a look at their life. And the person that's giving you advice, would you want to trade, you know, would you want to trade lives with them? And granted, you may not see a lot of things or whatever, but would you want to trade, you know, lives with them and what they would do for 24 hours? And if that answer is no, and you've prayed about it, and that answer is no, then that means you take what they say with a grain of salt and keep pushing. Everybody has an opinion. Everybody has, you know, things. I know there's things I may say. All of it may apply. None of it may apply. That's perfectly fine. But you have to pray and seek and, you know, talk to have that relationship to be like, you know, God, I heard this. And like, is this for me? You know, everything isn't for everybody, you know, and I understand that. And we all should understand that. But be careful who you allow in your space. And to know that that person should have your best interest at heart, especially your spiritual well-being and your emotional well-being. If they don't have those at their best interest, then you need to leave them at the door and leave them where they were at. Thank you so much for watching. I love you all. All of those who had requested that be in my prayer, you'll be in my prayer this evening. I normally do my prayers about 9 p.m. every evening. For those who've requested prayer, me going into the next week, anyone's going into the following week. I know a lot of people are getting ready to make that drive to work on tomorrow. I call them my corporate sponsor because they are, you know, but there's so much that can happen. So I'll definitely be keeping you guys in prayer. If there's any prayer requests, definitely log them in. I can be... You can hit me on Twitter at JuaNitaEGayNor. If you have a prayer request that you would like for me to do, just hit me up or any of my other social medias with the same name, Juanita E. Gaynor. And I would definitely, you know, make sure that I can keep you in prayer. Have a wonderful, wonderful evening. Be blessed. And we will definitely, definitely talk soon.